experience. But you've already gone ahead, and that's fine. And you might be doing your double leg stretch, both arms, both legs. And if you know the full version, you can take the arms and the legs into this circular position, which is how it was originally taught by Joe Pilates. And it's like a ballet plie, but we're lying down, of course. And hug your knees to your chest and rock your back from side to side to take a nice spinal release. And holding on to both knees now, let's press the knees outwards to release the lower back, the hips. Again, being aware of how this is all feeling to us, and taking that the other way. Nice big slow circle. And then take a moment to hug your knees to your chest while you release into your back. So just remain there for a couple of moments, holding that position and taking, again, calm breaths. When we're practicing Pilates, it's important that we practice calmly with deep, steady breathing, and therefore it becomes a mindful practice and helps us keep relaxed and keep calm, which is essential for all of our well-being. Look at shoulder bridge now. So again, you could use something here between your knees, because this will help your legs remain aligned and to activate your inner thighs. We also have the option of using one of these pressure mats, which are wonderful for helping you feel that you're in balance. So for this, I'm going to show you how that would work. You may have these things at home, and you come back down to the mat. Again, checking your ankles underneath your knees, toes pointing down the mat. And you can, when you've got acupressure mat or not, you could just rock a moment side to side. Check you've got equal weight on both shoulders, both hips, arms by your side. And we begin with a few spinal tilts. And this is wonderful, especially if you're on this pressure mat for back pain. And maybe this is your practice today, and that's fine. You would lie on the mat, you could be here about 20 minutes, and that in itself will give you a lovely pressure release, acupressure massage. And if you look at your back, you'll see it's all pink, so all the blood supplies come to your spine. We use these a lot at the studio here. From here, you can progress. So we begin to raise up bone by bone. And we're aiming to find each vertebra, one vertebra at a time. Inhale at the bottom, exhale to rise up, bone by bone. Inhale at the top, exhale, scooping hollow, pelvic floor lifts, navel back to spine, come back to neutral. So we don't want to twist the pelvis. You may like to hold on to your hips. And when you have both hips in the air, just check that both hips are equal. We're not tilting the pelvis, one hip going up or down. If we know this exercise well and we're not wobbling, we can add in the arms. We reach back, take the arms to the floor, inhale, and as we exhale, we lower the body bone by bone. Take another full stretch on the in, and exhale, you can bring the arms back down. Let's go again. Rising up bone by bone, inhale, and this time we use the exhale to come down and the inhale to lower the arms. A couple more times. Exhale. Inhale. Scooping and hollowing. Exhaling. Stretch the arms and bring the arms back down. Remove your item, whether it's a ball or a cushion. Massage your back, taking this into happy baby pose. So hold on the inside of your feet and bring your knees towards your armpits. Again, explore how this feels. Have a little bit of a rock. If this is really uncomfortable, you can put your toes together. You'll still get a good stretch in your buttocks. Or if you'd like to develop that, let's stretch the legs, pointing and flexing, and even drawing on the toes. And stretching the toes out a little more. You can bring the legs in and give yourself a hamstring stretch, stretching the back of the knees and holding on wherever you feel you need to, or bending your knees as much as you feel you need to. Bring the legs back down. We're going to come into single leg stretch now, so hands to the side of the head, lift the head, opposite elbow to opposite knee. So we're taking a full stretch of the leg, and the elbow meets the knee. Exhale as we go. If this troubles your neck, you could do it with your head down, but you're not going to get the rotation, but you could still go ahead. If you feel like to go a little bit stronger now, flex the foot and we can take it double time. If you're going to go double time, keep your technique. And this again is an exercise you can carry on with till you feel it. So when you feel you've had enough, that's fine, take a break, or just keep going until those ab muscles really feel it. And right now you're working these muscles on the side of your body known as the obliques. Take a moment to rest and we take the knees over to our left side. Right arm stretches out, drop the shoulder to the floor, press the ear to the floor and come to some full deep breathing. So breathing in